Welcome back. We are on map 2 between Fire and Todd. We are still in the group stage. We're still in group 1 of these Intellect Stream Masters Season 1 finals. And Fire is up 1-0 in a very convincing fashion. And he's going for Altar first again. He is the red human player who is spawning here in the on the left-hand side of Echo Isles. Whereas Todd is on the right-hand side. And he's going for Altar first, obviously, as well. And I'm assuming both of them are going to play AM, etc. And Todd seems to be a little bit tilted. Of course, he's been known to be one of the players who were the first to complain when anything wasn't basically up to their standards. And apparently Fire is just, you know, putting some salt in the wound. AM first for Todd and AM first for Fire. As expected. Barracks finished, first footman coming, etc. yeah. Fire, of course, this might be some psychological warfare at work. Of course, everyone knows and knew about Todd being not always in the greatest, not always having the greatest mindset, not always being the most relaxed player, rather emotional, and I guess he wants to get as much out of that as possible. So yeah, Scout by Todd has seen that there is nothing particularly unordinary going on by Fire, and Fire is actually pulling the militia immediately here. Todd on the other side is going to go for the little green one first, saving a little bit of lumber. And Fire, yeah, going for the instant expansion here. With 4 militia, of course he doesn't have a lot of lumber, or he's not gonna have a lot of lumber to work with here. I'm getting his water metal ensnared. But he's gonna have a second one soon. And Todd on the other side. Yeah, what is he gonna follow up with? Expansion immediately or mercenary camp first? That is the question. And it looks like probably the mercenary camp. Yes, that's what he's doing. So taking the expansion more slowly. Securing the assistance of mercenaries first. Or is he even gonna go for the expansion? That's the question. Perhaps he is. And Fire, after creeping here, heading across the map immediately. So he wants to get some creep checking going as quickly as possible. Todd has already secured himself the Forest Troll Shadow Priest and did find the Ring of Regeneration. Fire with whatever he found, he sold. So, no, he didn't even pick it up, right? Yeah, it's the Ring of Protection, which I'm assuming he's going to be picking up later. Todd waiting, apparently, for 19 o'clock when the Forest Troll Shadow Berserker is going to be available. And Fire does not have the patience for that. He's going right in for the main of Todd. Going to do some damage here to the peasants. Maybe he's going to be able to get rid of that low HP one. There's no way in hell he's going to be able to cancel that tower with all the peasants nearby. And there is the level 2 for him. And Todd is sitting in front of his natural here, and he just continues creeping. He wants to defend this with only militia in the tower. So far he's doing decently. 2 peasants have fallen, and he still hasn't started his tech, calling the militia right now, and he's pulling them towards the bottom. So he's gonna want to go for the expansion as well. He's gonna have it way later up than Fire, because Fire is already gonna have it finished in a second, whereas Todd has just is just about to finish creeping. But this time Todd is going to be the one with the XP advantage. He's up at level 3 against Fire, who's up at barely over level 2 only. So, reverse roles, but, you know, when compared to game 1, Fire this time has the economy advantage already. Whereas, of course, back on Turtle Rock, the economic situation was similar for both of them. Peasant just waiting here. Maybe he's gonna want to get the second Forest Troll Shadow Priest eventually. And Todd is getting his expansion as well. Fire has started taking already rather quickly. Not a single tower here. 1 tower here. There is some danger, I guess, of Todd applying some pressure right now with the level 3 plus the mercs against only level 2 without the mercs. And it looks like Fire wants to get rid of this mercenary disadvantage and the level disadvantage as quickly as possible. He's creeping his mercenary camp right now. And it looks like Todd, even though he's scouting with a water mantle right now, he doesn't have the necessary map awareness to dare heading across the map because, okay, this isn't gonna get too far. Because he was staying close to his expansion, he was defending, he was just taking a little creep camp right nearby just to be able to defend immediately in case Fire came around here, which clearly shows that he wasn't aware of the fact that Fire was back at his side of the map creeping, and he didn't want to risk Fire coming in here and killing everything and canceling the expansion, etc. Therefore, he was playing it safely, which I guess was the wrong choice here, because Fire is up at level 3 right now as well. Fire's got mercenaries right now as well. Even did pick up the one Forest Troll Shadow Priest here, so he's got two right now. 44 supply for him against 37 for Todd, who's still maintaining with this creep camp his little XP advantage for the moment. Then again, Fire heading across the map towards his main right now. Todd sees it with the footman. Let's see how he's reacting to it. And at the same time, he's trying to harass here with the footman. How much defense does Todd have here? Only one tower. Still, he hasn't even started teching, whereas Fire is soon to be done with that already. And he's found an energy pendant again. Todd getting rid of that mana on Fire's hero immediately. He doesn't pull back in time here, so he's not gonna have another water mantle. Some of the gold peasants have been called to arms here, but not all of the peasants. Just in order to defend this. And Todd has split his army here. He's got a few footmen down here to defend. He's got the rest of his army up here to defend, which is all fine and good. He started his tech right now as well, whereas Fire is already up at tier 2. And he's picked up the panda already, and it looks like he's going to want to keep the pressure up immediately. AM is going to have another water mantle available here, casting it immediately. Would have imagined him waiting for a little bit longer, because he's not going to have another one for a while anyway. And he's poking in here again, and again, Todd is at the bottom of the map. Todd wants to get over here, but he's not getting the chance to do so. Fire is at the top right, again, at the right time. And he's getting one kill, tech halfway done for Todd only. Breath of Fire should be coming in here any second. Yeah, now Breath of Fire is coming in. Plenty of repair going on the Arcane Tower, but one peasant after another is falling. The AM of Fire is probably going to be forced to use the Town Portal soon, but he's pulling back into Todd's base, and there's not really a lot of peasants remaining to deal damage to the AM, so I feel like he could have stayed in there for even a little bit longer, but it looks like he's done all the damage he wanted to casting. Who casted a lightning shield here? Todd, it was, but too late because Fire is already gone. Shop not yet finished for Fire, and he's going tier 3. Okay, so he's not going for mass casters breakers this time. One workshop, one Arcane Sanctum tier 3, so I imagine it's going to be Knights, Priests, and Mortar teams. And what's the play right now? Todd is once again trying to head across the map. Is he reaching tier 2? Yeah, in a few seconds, so he's gonna be able to pick up a Panda as well if he wants to. Whereas Fire, I would have expected him to maybe get level 3 on the Panda very quickly, but it looks like that's not going to be the plan here. 1,000 gold saved up for Todd, by the way. He's got no lumber at all. He buys the panda. He's got 700 gold, 5 lumber. He needs to reinvest into a lot of peasants here because he lost plenty of them previously, building peasants from both his expansion and his main base at the moment. Whereas Fire, he's got plenty of lumber. He's got a decent amount of gold. 55 supply for him against 52. Level almost 4 and 1 against level 3.5 and 1.5. So XP-wise, this is at least looking fairly similar. Second barracks is coming right now for Fire, so he's really, really going to want to get a lot of knights, apparently. And Call to Arms just used immediately, as well as the Town Portal. Looks like Fire just wants to prevent Todd from doing any damage here. And Town Portals are being exchanged, and on top of that, Todd is losing one Forest Troll Berserker. And both of them at the moment are just waiting for the attack to come up and for... Okay, some more harassment has gone on here, but not a single corpse, so I'm assuming this didn't really do too much. Not really sure where he just got the level up from. footman hiding behind the forest here. But Todd isn't chasing after them. He's going for the shop. He's getting Tom of retraining again very quickly here. Wondering, is this doing so much? 56 supply for Fire. Of course, Fire doesn't have any castles at the moment, so his take advantage is going to come into play into now. But it's not on the field yet, so maybe Todd is going to be able to make something happen here. 60 supply for Fire, 48 for Todd still. Panda's very underleveled on both sides, and is Todd going for tier 3 as well? He is, but he's behind basically an entire tech length. So Fire, I guess, just needs to hold out here, waiting. Oh, he's not building the Paladin here. Was about to say, just quickly wait for the Paladin, wait for the first two knights, which are about to spawn. And then you're good to go. Blizzard coming in, Fire still repositioning, still apparently doesn't feel quite ready. I mean, he's up by 16 supply, but most of that is in the pipeline. First knight is now out. Blizzard is hitting, well, medium at best. Fire's Panda is taking plenty of damage. Heal potion had to be used already. The mortar teams are nicely split. Todd is taking tons of damage on his AM. He needs to get going. He is taking way too much damage on his AM. The one forest troll shadow priest might be killed by Breath of Fire, but Todd doesn't get that in time. Now he's been healed up again. One footman is only falling. AM has to retreat. And on the other side, on the bottom of the map, we see one knight chasing after a couple of footmen and low HP mercenaries. So Fire is looking all good here once again. Still no Paladin. Okay, so it looks like he's gonna wanna stick to the two heroes. Only the knight has been able to chase down one of the Forest Troll Shadow Priest. The other one is healing the AM right now, and he's gonna get to the shop buying Scroll of Regeneration as well as Clarity Potion. And he's going to get into safety. The knight is doing a decent job blocking the panda here, bringing him down to 330 HP as well. Score of regeneration now used by Toto just to counter that. Fire is even self-killing two of his footmen right now. Maybe the third one as well? No, not quite, apparently. Just wants to make room for some more units, I'm assuming. Ring of Protection still not picked up.
Our forces are under attack.
Yeah, and flying machines are coming on top of that, so it seems like he's afraid of Todd countering this with griffins, because mortar teams have heavy armor, knights have heavy armor, everything is basically falling victim to griffins, and yeah, he's right. So did he scout this already? No, he didn't, but I guess it's not too hard to predict. And of course, he's in such a good position, why not invest into a few flying machines, just to make sure not to get surprised here and overwhelmed by a huge number of knights. Town portal is coming in. Todd does have a town portal as well, but he's not forced to use it. He's gonna lose a few of his footmen, but those are trash at this point anyway, so just make the best out of them, I guess, as long as they are at least of some value. 69 supply for Fire still. Panda of Todd with two rings of protection and a ring of regeneration still level 1, whereas Fire does have at least level 2 on his panda already. And the first bunch of flying machines are already out. Forest Troll Shadow Priest denied here by the panda. And is the, yeah, griffin production has already started. First griffin is out. And he's gonna have to go down here, because the knights are ripping apart Todd's economy at his expansion, while at the same time Fire is still able to win against Todd's army without them, and he's even forcing a town portal off of that panda with some nice blocking with his knight. The town portal is coming here, so these knights might be screwed at least. The panda does have to buy a potion though, I imagine. No, he doesn't even have to. The damage output of the griffins is just too high. So Todd has at least reached griffins right now. Let's see how much anti-air does Fire have on the field already. 6 flying machines. More to come. Only 1 workshop still. So is there a chance for Todd to come back here? Of course, a level 1 panda isn't going to do too much against the flying machines. Third griffin out. Todd with a paladin right now. Fire still only on 1 hero. On 2 heroes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 flying machines here still. More and more heading across the map. 6 flying machines against 3 griffins. Should still be fine though. Breath of Fire is coming in. The griffins immediately pulling back though. Maybe he should start counter-attacking, because as you can see, they snipe down flying machines very quickly. But the numbers might still be already too much in Fire's favor. Next Breath of Fire is coming in. The one griffin is being pulled back in time. No griffin has died yet on the ground. The knights are dominating though. Militia are coming in from the back, and all of the griffins have to pull back right now. Two more have spawned already. One has fallen. Both the pandas dancing around. It's a very, very chaotic fight. I'm assuming these militia down here will get annihilated in just a second. Paladin has to fall back as well. And the griffins actually in a good position here to snipe a couple of the knights, but at the same time, as I expected, all of the peasants have been taken down. 66 supplies still for Fire against 52 for Todd. But where is the anti-air for Fire? There are only a bunch of flying machines still around, and the griffins really, really get the chance to fight back here. Now pulling back above the forest where they can just take out the flying machines one by one, and I think they are very much going to do so. Breath of Fire going on Fire's Panda just after the Holy Light and the Heal Potion has been used by the Panda of Thought. Heal Potion passed and used by Fire as well, and I think he's gonna have to Town Portal here. Or he can just pass the staff, alright, fair enough. And use it, perhaps in time. Oh, he passed the Town Portal as well, so... Oh, he passed the Town Portal and he didn't use it! Wow, Fire really giving Thought the chance to come back into this game, but down here there's more units of Fire. Next flying machines are coming in. The Paladin level 2 has been reached, but he's probably not going to be focused down anytime soon anyway. And the griffins are being chased away. Another one is falling. Next Blizzard has come in. Did not particularly great. Divine Shield used by the Paladin just to get that Clarity Potion in. Slow on the griffin, and the next griffin is gonna fall, and it looks like Fire is really fighting back here in the air, even though he's only got his AM available at the moment. The Panda of Thought can buy another Heat Potion. There is one more Holy Light available on the Paladin. Sorceress is chasing after the Panda to cast the slow. Maybe, that's just now mana for a slow. And now the Paladin is going to be the one to get into trouble. Paladin is falling. Next Blizzard is going into the flying machines. The Griffin's still alive. And Thought is going to be forced to Town Portal here in just a second. With his AM, the Panda is also going to get away. Ah, he's gotta use the Town Portal though. Yeah, he does, just in time. The Panda, is he gonna get in range? Yes, he is. So Todd surviving for the moment. Does he have a shop up here? He doesn't, and he does have no healing up here. I think Fire doesn't realize it. What a freaking chaotic fight. But at the end of the day, Fire still has a large ground army. Fire still has barely enough anti-air to keep up with the Griffins here. And Todd has no means of healing here. And he's gonna lose the expansion. And are the mains empty already? Not quite. Blizzard Breath of Fire is coming in, but slow on the AM. There's no new Town Portal. And GG called by Todd. 2-0 for Fire in one very one-sided game. One game that looked pretty one-sided for a while, but I think Fire should have gotten a second workshop earlier on, to just have, instead of like 6-8 flying machines when that fight started, to have like 12, 14 maybe, and then he would have won the fight immediately. As it went, it was a very far stretched out fight. I'm sorry if I missed some stuff, but you know, gotta do what you can. But unfortunately, I cannot get more of the screen in at once than one screen size. So anyhow, Fire takes down Todd with 2-0, which means Fire is even on top of the group here at the end of the day, whereas Todd is ranked 2, LDC and Grubby are out of the tournament. Two humans advancing here in Group B, two Night Elves will be advancing. So we're gonna see two human against Night Elf matches in the winner bracket semifinals. And there are still two more matches to go in Group B, which are going to be Deadman against Creo and Hot against DD8. And Group A is done. I hope you enjoyed it. Fire definitely showing off here against Todd. Well, showing off is maybe the wrong term, but definitely proving that he's a player to be reckoned with. And we're gonna see how far he's gonna get in the last stage of the tournament, which will be the double elimination grid of the top four players. And Todd is, of course, going to have the chance to redeem himself as well. Anyhow, we'll next see Creo against Deadman. I hope you're looking forward to that. And as always, thumbs up, subscribe, comment, and I'll see you. Bye.